pretty far, but you know where you are, you're home.
And the friends that you choose want to walk in your shoes, you're home.
Anytime you feel your scars are falling,
look above, see a bright silver lining.
Listen up, that's your own freedom calling,
calling you to a day where you're shining.
Out of the darkness, ooh-ooh, into the spotlight, ooh-ooh, there is a new star, ooh-ooh, shining so bright. Ooh-ooh, out of the darkness, ooh-ooh, into the spotlight, ooh-ooh, there is a new star, ooh-ooh, shining so bright. In this place where we belong,
in this place where we belong.
So get up when you're down, 'cause this whole common ground is gone. I was lost, I was found, took the long way around, but I'm home.
You and me got the song that we're singing.
You and me got the drum that we're drumming.
Listen up to the changes we're bringing.
Nothing's going to stop us from coming. Out of the darkness, into the spotlight, there's a new star, shining so bright. Out of the darkness, into the spotlight, there's a new star, shining so bright. Every day's a chance, every day's a choice.
Even losers sometimes end up winning.
So go and find your dance, go and find your voice. But the party's only just place where we belong, and you'll hear us sing our song. In this place where we belong,
out of darkness,
into the spotlight,
into the spotlight,
there's a new star,
there is a new star,
shining so bright,
shining so bright.
Out of the darkness,
into the spotlight,
into the spotlight,
all your freedom,
all your freedom.
Good evening, and welcome to Stockton Civic Theatre's second annual Young at Heart Concert Gala. From the Board of Directors and the Youth Theatre Education Committee, we would like to thank you for supporting youth theatre education. I'm Joe Smith, and I'm the current Board President here at Stockton Civic Theatre. From the Board of Directors and from myself, we would like to give you all a big thank you for joining us this evening. Since February of 2020, when we closed our last production, Stockton Civic Theatre has been dark due to the COVID-19 pandemic. And we have been working hard as a board and as theatre employees to come up with creative and outside-the-box thinking ways to bring you live theatre. Tonight, you will experience our first attempt at bringing you a virtual online concert. At any point during tonight's concert, you can donate by texting Young at Heart to 44321. You can visit our website at sctlivetheater.com. You can call 209-473-2424, or if you're watching on our campaign page, click the Donate Now button below. Now sit back and enjoy all the wonderful talent to follow.
Hi, I'm Jordy Beretta. And today I'm going to be singing I See Stars from Mean Girls the Musical. A little bit about me. The last thing you could have seen me in was Hairspray as Tracy Turnblad at Lincoln High School in the spring of 2018. But you could have also seen me in some of the SCT Jr productions, or potentially even the main stage shows. I was in The Addams Family as an ancestor and in Sister Act as a nun, both incredible experiences that I would not trade for anything. I learned so much about acting, singing, and just being, you know, a respectful artist. And I made so many great friends. But I'd say that my favorite youth experience, specifically at SCT, would probably be Willy Wonka Jr. And I believe this summer of 2014. So I was actually 14 years old, and I was at a point in my acting career where I wasn't really sure what I wanted to do. And I thought that, you know, a role, having a named important role, was the biggest, most important part of theater. But that experience actually taught me that you can make the most out of anything and teach yourself so much. Because I wasn't actually a named character or anything, but the directors decided to take one song and give it to me and have that be my character, is just the singer of that song. And it was a really eye-opening experience that you can make such a big impact with something that small, that you don't have to dominate the whole show to be important or to showcase what you can bring to the table. And I have grown up using that principle in my acting, and now I'm studying musical theater at Chico State and will be performing this fall for one of their main stage shows virtually. But yeah, I'm really excited to be involved in this concert, and a big, huge thank you to James Reed for including me. And yeah, I can't wait. Thank you.
Cheap, fake, easy to break. That's how I used to be.
Here, take it.
Now I'm awake, I'll tell you what I see. Plastic don't shine, glitter don't shine, rhinestones don't shine the way you do. You are so real, you are so rare. We see you there, I see you. I see stars, so many stars tonight. You could make diamonds shine.
Hello and good evening. My name is Alyssa Harris, and I'm an SCT board member, a former SCT Jr participant, and a current SCT Jr parent. And I'm here to guide you on your virtual journey tonight. Our concert's theme, Young at Heart, was chosen to honor the child inside all of us. The child that found love, the child that chased their dreams, the child that found happiness. I'm also here to tell you how easy it is to donate. Text Young at Heart to 44321. Go to our website at www.sctlivetheater.com. Call the theater at 209-473-2424. Or if you're watching from our campaign page, click the big Donate Now button. We are here to celebrate the power of youth theater education by hearing from current and former SCT Jr. participants and enjoying their musical talents. Throughout the evening, James Reed, SCT Jr. Program Director, will be interviewing current SCT Jr. participants. Let's hear from one of them now.
Welcome to another interview from some of our SCT Jr. students. Here with me, I'm going to let her introduce herself. We have...
Hi, my name is Gianna Smith.
Perfect. And Gianna, how long have you been involved with SCT Jr.?
I have been involved with SCT Jr. for 2 years now.
Perfect. How old are you and what school do you go to?
I am 13 years old and I go to Sierra Middle School.
Perfect. I'm going to just ask you a couple of questions for our audience. What is your favorite moment from SCT or SCT Jr.?
One of my favorite moments from SCT or SCT Jr. is getting to meet everyone and hearing how they started theater and how they're planning on continuing theater. For example, Grace Grimmel, she is so talented, and I met her during Annie a couple years ago, and she stood out to me because she is so hardworking and makes sure she can hit everything she needs to and excel from it.
What does theater education mean to you, and why is it important?
Theater education means to me it's a place where you can come and learn how to become a greater actor or learn tech work like sound design or spotlight work. A place that kicked this all off for me was Kudos. It was a place where you could go and learn how stage design worked and play structure work. And it really taught me how to voice and bring emotion into a certain character.
Cool. What is one thing, or what would you tell your friends about SCT Jr. and why they should be a part of this?
I would tell my friends that it's a great community and you can meet so many great people and make so many amazing memories.
Perfect. Gianna, thank you so much for your time. I appreciate this. It was so much fun. Everyone, now back on to our next performer.
Hi, my name is Gavin Letta, and I am 9 years old and a fourth grader at Brookside Elementary School. My first theater experience was only last fall when I got casted as Tommy in Matilda the Musical at Stockton Civic Theater. That had to be one of the best and most fun things I have ever done, and it is what made me fall in love with theater. Tonight I am singing My House from Matilda the Musical by Tim Minchin. In the show, it is sung by Miss Honey. For those of you who aren't familiar with Matilda the Musical, Miss Honey is Matilda's teacher, and she had to teach Matilda and her classmates under very difficult circumstances. Sound familiar? So tonight, I am dedicating this performance to my teachers and all the teachers out there that are doing their best under different but also very difficult circumstances. Thank you for all that you do for us.
This chair I
It isn't much, but it is enough for me. It isn't much, but it is enough for me.
Hi everyone, my name's John Thiel. I was last seen in Stockton Civic's production of Mary Poppins in 2016. When I think of a favorite memory of youth theater, out of many cherished moments of performances and collaborations with young people and other artists, one of the shows that comes to mind is Xanadu. That was just such a fun production to be a part of, and this title song to the show is often stuck in my head. So a shout out to everyone who was a part of that production and who watched us perform. Today I'm going to be singing Corner of the Sky by Stephen Schwartz from the musical Pippin. And I dedicate it to every theater artist, young and old, who are pursuing their passions.
Everything has its season. Everything has its time. Show me a reason and I'll soon show you a rhyme. Cats fit on the windowsill, children fit in the snow. Why do I feel I don't fit in anywhere I go? Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my corner of the sky. Everyone has their daydreams. Everyone has their goal. People like the way dreams have of sticking to the soul. Thunderclouds have their lightning. Nightingales have their song. And don't you see, I want my life to be something more than long. Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my corner of the sky. So many of us seem destined to settle for something small. But I won't rest until I know we'll have it all. So don't ask me where I'm going, but listen when I'm gone. And far away you'll hear me singing softly to the dawn. Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my corner. Of the sky.
My name is Otter. 20 years ago, I was 8 years old, and my very first production here at Stockton Civic Theatre, it was The Sound of Music, where I played Kurt Von Trapp. I feel so blessed to be back here in Stockton on this stage playing a song for you. This is an original I wrote for the occasion. This is called Put It in the Air.
Thank you. haven't seen the sunshine in forever. I'm sick of the cloud. I'm sick of the shade. And it feels like the artist is on trial now for what he paints, story he tells. Like a dancer who was dancing alone in an empty room while she waits to dance for you. Out the window she can see that there are people wanting her to lose and turn into someone she did not choose. There's something in the air. The ground just started shaking right beneath our feet. Our hearts are beating louder, yeah. There's something in the air. And it's no good for breathing, but we won't lose our dreams to someone else's power. Everybody locked up, becoming alcoholics. Boys being shot down for walking home. How did we get here? Pass down the generational knowledge. It's all we have now. It's all we own. And it's what we need to share. So put it in the air. The chains we wear need breaking, falling off our feet. Don't let nobody scare you, not, not, no. Put it in the air. The time is now for speaking. Go yell it in the street, 'cause I just wanna hear you.
What a great performance. Thank you. Thank you. I'm excited to introduce two lovely people who have been involved with our summer program. I'll let them introduce themselves.
Hi, I'm Melissa Campos. I am the mother of Nico Campos, and I am actually a friend of James. We met when we were 14 years old in community theater, just like SCT Jr. in Manteca, and we've known each other ever since.
Yes.
Hi, my name is Nico Campos. I was a student for SCT Jr. online summer program, and I go to online academy school, and I am in the fifth grade.
Excellent, excellent. Okay, so we're going to start right off the bat. What is one of your favorite moments from SCT or SCT Jr.?
Go ahead, Nico.
One of my favorite moments from SCT Jr. is meeting famous stars from Broadway. One of my favorite stars was
Dane
Jesperson, and when he taught us dancing from Hamilton.
That was pretty cool. Yeah. I actually liked watching them learn from all of the different actors, too. It was super cool. So, yeah, Dane was one of my favorites.
Perfect. What does theater education mean to you, and why is it important?
So, when I am not busy, I teach dance sometimes, and watching my students learn is super, super rewarding as their teacher. But seeing them socialize and their confidence grow is so important for theater education, and getting kids involved early and exposing them to different music and cultural information is going to last them their lifetime.
I think it's important for people to socialize, because in the midst of a pandemic, you don't get a lot of the socialization, which could sometimes be...
just make you sad.
Yeah, kind of sad. So SCT Jr. can help with that. After this pandemic, you can help. SCT Jr. can help you socialize.
By making more friends, huh?
Yeah, by making more friends and doing theater, just like how my mom changed.
Yeah. Perfect. And I know we were talking earlier, you were saying if you had to describe theater education, there was three things that you wanted to say that it reminded you of. Do you remember those three things?
It's fun, educational, and meet new people.
Perfect. I love that you had to write it down. I appreciate that. I remember that we write it down. I got my notes too. It helps me. Okay, we're going to jump into our next question. What would you tell your friends or little brother to get them to want to be a part of SCT Jr. next summer?
Go ahead. You can meet new people, and you could also meet Broadway stars, which would be really cool. Also, you could do plays, like different types of plays, which would be really cool and fun.
And then, Melissa, how would you tell parents, like, if they had that same question, like, why should my kid be a part of SCT Jr.? Why this one?
So as a mom that loves theater and is involved with theater here locally, there's not really a ton of opportunities for kids to get involved with theater. And the program at SCT Jr. is exceptional. They have incredible teachers that are well-versed in their crafts. And the kids just really learn so much from them. And they relate really, really well from their instructors. And I think that opportunity that SCT Jr. provides for them is second to none for the area.
So are you guys, well, that's it for my questions, but I do have one question left before we go. Are you guys enjoying the performances so far?
We are, yeah.
You guys ready for some more?
Yes, we are. We can't wait to sing along.
Well, thank you so much, you guys. Have a great evening. It was good talking.
Hi, my name's Emmy Fuji. My favorite moment from Stockton Civic Theatre was when I played Lavender and Matilda, because everyone from the cast and crew was just so kind and caring and collaborative, and if you were to burst out in song, everyone else would just start singing with you. And today I'll be singing one of the cut songs from Shrek the Musical called More to the Story. And I'm singing this because I feel like everyone has that one moment where they wanted to say something, but it comes out wrong and nothing goes as planned. And that's kind of how it is right now, because we all thought we'd be going back to school, going back to work, seeing our friends and our family, but unfortunately we can't do that. Thank you. This is by the book, a picture perfect bride. I got my happy ending in a fairy tale, the knot must get tied. This is what I dreamed. Finally. So there's more. be cool. Bing goes with bad, and royal goes with duty. We play our part, we follow every rule. This is by the book. I knew it from the start.
It's so nice to have you in again. Now take off that hat. Let's see what we're working with. Oh no. Honey, did you give yourself a coronavirus cut? You did. Okay. You feeling stressed, honey? Okay. Well, sit down. Why don't you take a seat? Let me put on some music for you, okay? Relaxing. It's called Celtic Moods. When I'm overwhelmed because of Corona, I play this and it never fails. I pretend like I'm in Ireland with Enya and the whales. When PG&E cuts off my power, and I'm spending the whole night alone, I pretend like I'm in Ireland, where the Irish bagpipes drone. Smell the grass as the rainstorm is ending. People smile as they stroll past their farms. And a red-headed sailor named Brendan, and we dance less than 6 feet apart. It could be worse, let me tell ya. In a bar once I met this guy, Dewey, and he bought me like 14 beers. And he told me that he was from Ireland, so I lived with him 10 years. If I squinted, he looked like my sailor, the one that I had dreamed of in the past. But he dumped me for some punk named Kayla, took my trailer and took my cat. In Ireland they know how to love you, 'cause they all choose to put on their mask. And if you feel that the world is ending, just remember that this too shall pass. Well, honey, we're gonna get through it, okay? 'Cause a person such as you has a future. You have hope as each new day dawns. Friends like you always get to see Ireland. Give my love to
to the leprechauns. Honey. Honey, see? Oh, don't you feel better? Now let's fix that hair.
We would now like to take the time to introduce the Young at Heart Award. This award was created to honor someone who has been instrumental in youth theater education within SCT and the Stockton community. But this year, we're doing it a little differently. Come with me.
The person we would like to honor tonight is deeply rooted in the Stockton Civic Theater family. She made her debut at SCT in 1959 at the age of 16 in Dark at the Top of the Stairs and has been involved with SCT ever since. She is not only a co-chair for the Footlighters and a member of the SCT board, but she also wears many hats on production teams. She has been involved with SCT Jr. Productions in many capacities, mainly as choreographer. She also fosters youth theater education in the Stockton community as a whole, and has directed fantastic productions at local elementary schools. She's received numerous SCT Willie Awards for her performances, as well as the Stockton Arts Commission Star Award, the Lane Fields Award, the Founders Award, and she was inducted into the Edison High School of Fame for Lifetime Achievement. This year's Young at Heart Award goes to Judy Williamson.
Congratulations! So it's all a ploy. We want to present you this year with the Young at Heart Award for SCT.
You are kidding.
And so we couldn't do it live, so we're going to capture it, and it's going to get filmed live for the actual presentation. So we wanted to present it to you.
Oh my God! Oh, that's so nice. Oh, that is.
We are now going to take a short 5-minute break, which will allow you to go bid on the silent auction prizes. Just a reminder, the silent auction closes at 10 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Now go bid, we have some amazing items. You can also take these 5 minutes to participate in our social media door prize giveaway. The instructions will pop up on the screen shortly, so pay attention. Please also take the time to consider donating to Stockton Civic Theater so that we can keep youth theater education going. Just a reminder, there's 4 ways you can donate. You can text Young at Heart to 44321, visit the theater webpage at sctlivetheater.com, call the box office at 209-473-2424, or if you're watching from our campaign page, you can click the big Donate Now button. Enjoy, and we'll see you back in 5 minutes.
Thanks, Five.
What I've learned from the SCT Junior online program is new songs, new dances, how a professional audition goes, and so much more. I'd just like to thank everyone who helped make SCT Junior online happen, because it's been tough for the theater community since COVID's happened, and to put on theater, mainly you have to be all together. So I'm glad we've been able to learn all these new things online and safe. Thank you.
What I learned from the SCT Junior's online summer program is I learned different dance moves, steps, and I also learned what it feels like to be an understudy on Broadway.
Thank you.
Hi, my name's Gavin, and I had so much fun doing SCT Jr's 2020 online summer program. One thing that I learned is how to develop a character. For example, what is my character's favorite food? What's its favorite color? What's its favorite clothes to wear? And I bring that all into how I act as that character. Thank you to all the wonderful coaches and guest artists, and to everyone out there that supports Stockton Civic Theatre.
What I have learned from SCT Jr's 2020 online program is many audition skills and character voicing skills. Auditioning and accents are not my strong spots, and now with all the notes that I have, I'll be able to make them my strong spots, along with the dancing and emotions. Can't wait to do SCT Jr next year, no matter if it's online or in the theater, because I'll be doing what I love to do best, and that is to act.
Hello, my name is Samantha Snyder, and these are some things that I learned at the SCT Jr. online program. One of the things I learned was beginner's ballet, multiple dances and songs, how to make posters online, and how to make a website. Thank you!
What I have learned in the SCT Jr 2020 online program is how to break down a monologue, how to find and cut an audition song, and I've also learned several dances. I want to thank all of my instructors, especially Grace Grimmel and James Reed. Thank you and have a great day.
Hello, my name is Maya Farias, and something I learned from SCT Jr. Summer 2020 program is that there are just different styles of theater. So there's like radio plays, normal plays, musicals. Also, I learned that you need to be confident when on stage and make sure that you can do it and always reassure yourself that you're able to do it. And that is what I learned. Thank you for listening.
Welcome back. I'm Dennis Beasley, Artistic Director here at Stockton Civic Theatre. Before we go any further, we would like to thank Octavio's, The Black Rabbit, Say Soleil, and Toot Sweet for their delicious food and wine. Also, another big thank you to all of our silent auction and raffle donors. Without your support, none of this would have been possible. I hope you're enjoying tonight's entertainment. While the pandemic has created many challenges for us, SCT is committed to continuing to produce even if we can't have our audience physically in the building. We are currently in rehearsal for The Last 5 Years, which will be our first streaming full production. The Last 5 Years is Jason Robert Brown's intimate look into a couple's passionate, short-lived marriage. Kathy, a struggling actress, and Jamie, a budding novelist on the brink of wild success, are 20-somethings in New York who meet, fall in love, marry, and divorce over the span of 5 years. We see key moments of the relationship from the perspective of each of the characters. We see Kathy's perspective from the end of the marriage moving backward, and Jamie's begins when they first meet. They only come together once in the musical, at their wedding. We're very excited to present this intensely intimate two-person musical. The Last 5 Years will be available on demand starting Thanksgiving weekend. Check out the SCT Facebook page and website for deals on how to get tickets and watch. Also keep an eye out for future productions. We hope to announce a holiday project soon that will run in December. We are also keeping August Osage County on the back burner so that we will be able to perform that show as soon as we are allowed to have audiences back in the building. Of course, we still have our fantastic 70th season planned and cannot wait to bring that to you whenever we are able. With all that said, let's get back to tonight's performances. Please don't forget to donate if you can. Text Young at Heart to 44321 or visit sctlifetheater.com or call 209-473-2424 to donate, or you can just click the big Donate Now button on the campaign page. Please enjoy the rest of the show.
Hi, my name is Lydia Kay, and you last saw me on the SCT stage in 2018, Company, with my husband, Thomas Smith. I started acting in musical theater productions when I was 10 years old, and I never really stopped once I started. They call it a bug for a reason. I was very shy as a kid, pretty passive, and I found that the theater environment really gave me that opportunity of a safe space that was filled with supportive people who shared similar interests, who really understood me. So I had the opportunity to be vulnerable and stretch those legs and grow as a person. And I took what I learned in theater as a child and applied it in other areas of my life. So school when I was a kid and as I went through college and grad school. But also in my work environment to this day, I find myself applying the things that I've learned with my experience in youth theater. I have great memories of that time in my life and a lot of feelings of fulfillment, both on the stage and off. Today, we will be singing Love is an Open Door from Disney's Frozen, which is something that reverberates around our house here with our 3-year-old daughter Phoebe and our 1-year-old son Arlo. So I hope you enjoy.
Okay, can I just say something crazy?
I love crazy.
All my life has been a series of doors in my face, and then suddenly I bump into you.
I was thinking the same thing, 'cause like, I've been searching my whole life to find my own place, and maybe it's the party talking or the chocolate fondue.
But with you
I found my place.
I see your face,
and it's nothing like I've ever known before. Love is an open door. Love is an open door. Love is an open door.
With you.
Love is an open door. I mean, it's crazy.
What?
We finish each other's
sandwiches.
That's what I was gonna say.
I never met someone who thinks so much like me.
Jinx! Jinx again! Our mental synchronization can't have but one explanation. You
and I
were
just meant to be. Say goodbye to the pain of the past. We don't have to feel it anymore. Love is an open door. Love is an open door.
Can I say something crazy? Will you marry me?
Can I say something even crazier? Yes!
Another big thank you we need to give tonight is to Nick Elliott and his late partner, Bill Grotemeyer, for their love of youth theater and for keeping SCT Jr. in their hearts. The mission of the Bill Grotemeyer Fund is to increase access to theater education and continue the legacy of Bill's love of the arts. Since its genesis, the fund has awarded over $3,000 in scholarships and financial assistance. And after tonight, we hope to increase its activism for theater education in the Stockton community. And now, the first Bill Grotemeyer College Scholarship recipient, Brogan Keener, will read a letter from Nick Elliott so we can all get to know the fund's wonderful namesake.
A Founders Award recipient for his many years of service to Stockton Civic Theater, Bill Grotemeyer was as close to the birth of SCT as having appeared in the 1956 production of Member of the Wedding when he was in sixth grade. Another acting stint of Bill's was as Joffrey in Lion in Winter in 1970. This was followed by a series of directorial tasks starting in the 1972-73 season with Angel Street and continuing to his final production of Ladies at the Alamo in the 1982-83 season. Bill was artistic committee chairman during SCT's transition from the Willow and Monroe site to the current Rose Marie Theater facility. In 2009, Bill became involved in SCT's collaboration with Stockton Unified School District's Center Stage program, serving persons with developmental disabilities, coordinated by Bobby Wallinger. Bill served as drama and line coach for three shows until 2012, with some 80 students ages 3 to 73 who participated in the productions on the SCT stage. According to Wallinger, Bill was beloved by the students. A junior high language arts teacher with Lodi Unified School District for 32 years, Bill was an avid supporter of SCT's youth program over the years. In his modest, unassuming way, he maybe would be embarrassed to have this scholarship named in his honor. But his years of commitment to Stockton Civic Theater warrants such an honor. And for that, the youth of SCT are grateful. Thank you, Nick. And thank you, Bill, for your love of youth theater.
Hi, my name is Miguel Chicas, and you would have seen me participate in shows at Stockton Civic Theater in 2009 to 2013. I participated in shows like Joseph and the Amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat, Are You Being Served, 42nd Street, Hairspray, and Anything Goes. I currently live in Orange County, California, and I teach chorus, 4th through 8th grade chorus, in Irvine Unified School District. I'm doing chorus, and I got into music because of my experience in high school where I got to do the arts and participate in things like theater. I attended St. Mary's High School, and I studied under the direction of Kevin Costello, and he made the theater program an incredible theater program. It was so much fun, so engaging. We got to really express ourselves. And that was something that, in myself, I was really quiet and shy, and he really brought out a different side of me, where I got to really be goofy, and it was okay for me to do that. And I got to learn how to tap dance. I got to learn how to do all these amazing things because of the mentors I had in high school. And so that's something I currently hope to do and pass on to students, my students that I have. For tonight, what I will be singing, Wandering from the Bridges of Madison County by Jason Robert Brown.
A little twinge, a little shock, a little whisper at the bottom of your memory. A sudden wind, a gentle knock, and then a rustle in the leaves. You hold your breath, you check the lock, you reassure yourself there's nothing at the window. But you're wandering. Nothing's gonna happen. Nothing's gonna happen. You turn a key, you flip a switch, you settle back into the blissful unfamiliar. You close your eyes, but there's an itch, a little hurt your heart retrieves. But you ignore the tiny twitch, pretend the feeling will be gone before the morning. But you're wandering, you're wandering, you're wandering where you are. Nothing's gonna happen. Nothing's gonna happen. But wouldn't it be fine to share the weather in her eyes, her hair, her footsteps as she climbs the stair, the shadow in her light. But everything you know is true, and everything you want to do, and everything that makes you you collides against the night. And nothing's black and white. But you're wandering, you're wandering.
Hi everyone, my name is Layla Yu, and it's already been more than a decade since my very first show at SCT, which is crazy to think about, but I am absolutely thrilled to be virtually reunited for Young at Heart 2020. My favorite moment on stage has to just be the camaraderie of theater all in all. You're not just performing with your fellow castmates on stage, you also perform with the stagehands, everyone in lighting and sound and set design, the musicians in the orchestra pit. An immensely talented and eclectic group of people come together simply for the magic of storytelling. And to everyone tuning in, thank you so much for supporting youth arts programming and to Stockton Civic Theatre. Everyone there has continued to find innovative ways to just keep the community going during this time. And to all the young performers out there, I believe in you. Don't ever stop creating. And I hope I'll be able to see you shine on stage soon. Without further ado, here is Colors of the Wind from Disney's Pocahontas.
You think I'm an ignorant savage. Well, you've been so many places, I guess it must be so. But still I cannot see if the savage one is me. How can there be so much that you don't know? You don't know. You think you own whatever land you land on. The earth is just a dead thing you can claim. But I know every rock and tree and creature has a life, has a spirit, has a name. You think the only people who are people are the people who look and think like you. But if you walk the footsteps of a stranger, you'll learn things you never knew, you never knew. Have you ever heard the wolf cry to the blue corn moon? the grinning bobcat why he grinned. Can you sing with all the voices of the mountains? Can you paint with all the colors of the wind? Can you paint with all the colors of the wind? Come run the hidden pine trails of the forest. Come taste the sun-sweet berries of the earth. Come roll in all the riches all around you, and for once, never wonder what there were. The rainstorm and the river are my brothers. The heron and the otter are my friends. And we are all connected to each other in a circle, in a hoop that never ends. How high will the sycamore grow? If you cut it down, then you'll never know. And you'll never hear the wolf cry to the blue corn moon. For whether we are white or copper skinned, we need to sing with all the voices of the mountains. We need to paint with all the colors of the wind. You can own the earth and still all you'll own is earth until you can paint with all the colors of the wind. Thank you, everyone. Stay safe and healthy. Take care.
Good evening. I'm so happy and honored to be telling you all, especially the younger people, about a dear friend of mine that Stockton Civic Theater lost this year. Dorothy Blaze Mulvihill, known as Dottie to most people, was a member of SCT's family for almost 50 years. She devoted so much of her 86 years with us, she really became an icon of excellence for all of her talents, on and off the stage, and in theater teaching, whether that be in classrooms in Stockton, Manteca, or at SCT. She taught for 6 years at Amos Alonzo Stagg High School and 30 years at Manteca High School. She taught drama, dance, English, and creative writing. Her work at SCT spans from 1961 with the musical Guys and Dolls, which was performed at Madison Elementary School in the auditorium, to The Miracle Worker and many others at our theater at Willow and Monroe Streets, and eventually to our Rosemary Lane site. She was performing, directing, choreographing, and of course, costuming. She had marvelous sewing skills and design abilities. She loved costuming and was always historically accurate for any period style. Theater history, playwrights, and the knowledge of thousands of plays were other subjects of which she was a master, lucky for her students. Dottie was offered the director position at Manteca High School. In taking it, she found it necessary to leave SCT to do everything needed to maintain a full-time high school drama department. When she retired, Manteca named the auditorium for Dorothy, a well-deserved honor. When she returned to SCT, Dottie was in demand for all the things she had done before leaving, plus being put in charge of the costumes, and when Greg Morales became artistic director in 1996, he appointed Dottie to head the youth theater program. She loved this, as she always loved teaching and developing the knowledge, skills, and love and appreciation of theater in young people, and eventually in adults too, with classes at SCT and Delta College. She produced musicals with the summer student programs. Doing shows like Schoolhouse Rock and Dear Edwina, she added co-musical directors and choreographers and technical directors to enhance the production and learning. She also had the first touring children's theater program when she took the musical Honk to summer school classes in different area schools. Dottie was keen on diction. She wanted the audience to understand every word, whether in a song or straight dialogue. Knowing your blocking and being consistent were stressed too, being a dancer. Hit your marks, learn lines accurately, listen and react. All the things a director expects for an excellent show, whether it's a student or adult cast. Plus, have fun. Her own performances, whether musicals, heavy dramas, or light comedies, were a testament to her versatility and talent as an actress and a true theatrical presence. Audiences look forward to being entertained and enlightened by her performances and professionalism. Her natural, generous, and classical qualities were teaching elements for her students, too. For these reasons and more, I wish the younger people and performers could have known and learned from her. She would have been a touchstone for their theater education and appreciation of all parts of the theater magic. Dottie's impact at Stockton Civic Theater will be everlasting, and she will definitely be missed, not forgotten, but always appreciated, respected, and loved.
Living here in this brand new world might be a fantasy. I'm Grace Gamel, and you just last saw me virtually as a part of the SCT Junior program this summer when I had the honor of directing The Wee Triple Swine of Farfine, and I was a part of Twelfth Night as Orsino. The last thing that I did in person was Matilda as a part of the ensemble, which was an absolute blast. At the moment, I'm currently a part of the Valley Youth A Cappella, and I'm doing speech and debates. And I would have to say that my favorite youth theater experience definitely has to go to Xanadu Junior, which was my very first SCT production. And I just had such an absolute joy bringing Kira to life and getting to do her Australian accent. And every single time I hear a song or a reference to Xanadu Junior, I just instantly have the biggest smile on my face because it is one of my favorite shows because it introduced me to SCT and to so many wonderful people. Speaking of SCT, I am so excited to be part of the Young at Heart concert / fundraiser, and I will be doing a mashup of Maybe and Tomorrow from Annie, and I was in Annie as Annie 2 years ago, and it's one of my fondest memories, and it was my first main stage production at SCT. And yeah, I'll be doing a mashup of those two songs today, lyrics by Martin Sharnan. Thank you, and I hope you enjoy.
Maybe for all pouring her coffee, she may be straightening his tie. Maybe in a house all hidden by a hill, she's sitting playing piano, he's sitting paying a giving up me.
Thank you so much. That was a great performance. And now we are back with more questions with some of our SCT Junior students, and I'm going to let them introduce themselves.
Hi, I'm Ruby James. I'm 13 years old. You may recognize me from the role of Matilda in Matilda the Musical and from SCT Junior's 2020 online program.
And side note, congratulations on your Ellie win.
Thank you.
My name is Alice James, and you might recognize me from the SCT Junior online radio play, Three Little Pigs.
Perfect. We're going to jump right into some of the questions. What is one of your favorite moments from SCT or SCT Junior?
My favorite moment from SCT is probably opening night of Matilda, because that was sort of the halfway point of one of the greatest experiences of my life. Matilda has always been a dream role for me ever since I started doing theater and heard about the musical. I put it on my bucket list of roles. And when the opportunity came up, we knew it was a long shot, but we decided to try it out, and we did. And I got in, and it was kind of surreal. I didn't really realize and soak it in until closing night and realize, wow, okay, that actually just happened.
How about you, Alice?
Well, one of my favorite moments was one of the first online classes for SCT Junior, and I was super excited because it was the first thing I've done anything like that, and it's offered a lot of opportunities.
Excellent, excellent. Okay, so next question. What does theater education mean to you, and why is it important?
Theater education and theater in general are important to me because it really helped me to boost my confidence. When I was younger, I was very shy. I didn't like talking to anybody that I didn't know very well. But once I started getting myself into theater and educating myself on theater, I began to open up quite a bit. Like, now I'm that person who walks down the street giving people free high fives. And it's really important for kids that feel closed off or socially separated to do theater, even if they don't plan to pursue it as a career, because it can still help to open you up and boost your confidence.
Perfect. Alice?
So, for me, sometimes I just need a break from life, and so theater education is important for me because it teaches me how to use theater as an outlet to let out all my emotions, and it lets me be someone else for a little while.
Perfect, perfect. Okay, next question. What would you tell your friends interested in and why they should join SCT Junior next summer?
I would probably tell my friends that my experiences with SCT Junior were amazing. I thoroughly enjoyed myself. It was a great way to spend my summer. All of the kids were very nice, and the instructors were amazing. And I learned a lot of things about theater that I definitely did not know before. And working with the Broadway stars was really cool. And if that didn't convince them to do it, I don't know what would.
Yep. Okay. And you, Alice, what would you tell your friends?
I would tell them a lot of that stuff, And I would also tell them that you don't have to do the theater part. You can also do the crew and behind the scenes stuff, because SCT Jr. also offers that.
I love my crew kids. Okay. Perfect. Well, that was it. I thank you so much for jumping on for this Zoom call for them. I want to know, are you guys enjoying the show so far?
Yeah, it's been great.
Good. You guys ready for some more?
Yes.
Okay, can't wait.
I'm going to let you guys go, but thank you so much for joining. We're going to get to our next entertainer. You two have a great evening. Good night.
Bye. Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Matthew Baker, and I graduated Bird College in England for musical theatre in 2008. Since then, I performed in and around London on various cruise ships, including Royal Caribbean and Disney Cruise Line. I then moved to the USA and performed regionally and on tour with shows such as Saturday Night Fever as Tony Manero and Something Rotten as Shakespeare. The song I'm going to be performing this evening, I discovered in 2005 when I was at college in my education years. This song is from a show called Elegies for Angels, Punks, and Raging Queens. It is entitled, And the Rain Keeps Falling Down. Enjoy.
My friend, it's raining again today. I never understood why you chose to stay in a climate that's mostly wet and gray, when what you loved was a sun so hot it turned the green grass brown and the rain. The rain
As we close the night, on behalf of myself, the SCT Board, and Stockton Civic Theatre, we would like to give a big thank you to our donors. Thank you to Octavio's, The Black Rabbit, Say Soleil, and Toot Sweets for catering our virtual tables. Thank you so much to our silent auction donors. Speaking of the silent auction, bidding is open until 10 p.m. tonight, so go visit the site and bid. And lastly, thank you to you for showing up tonight and supporting the arts. Please also remember to donate in one of four ways. You can text Young at Heart at 44321, visit the theater webpage at sctlivetheater.com, call the box office at 209-473-2424, or if you're watching from our campaign page, you can click the big Donate Now button. Now, let's welcome to the screen a group of talented young ladies for our closing number of the evening. Thank you, good night, and be safe.
We're one of a kind.
No category.
Too many years.
Lost in his story.
We're free
to take our crowning glory for 5 more minutes. We're 6.
Everybody knows that we used to be six wise. But we wanna say before we drop the curtain, nothing is for sure, nothing is for certain. All that we know is that we used to be saints.
We're six.